I really did accept Muhammad's message from God. Muhammad's message from God.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome back to Righteous Companions. And we are talking about the faithful friend of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the second of the two, Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. And at the beginning of the episode, we said that Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu was given that status of the truthfulness. Also, he was given the glad tiding of Jannah while he is living here in the face of this earth. Now, how did he earn that? How did he gain that? Because he's the Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and he's the friend of the Messenger? No. لَيْسَ بِأَمَانِيُّكُمْ وَلَا أَمَانِي أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ It is not wishful thinking. If you want to get to Jannah, if you want to be elevated in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must work. You must work. Look at Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And the حديث في صحيح البخاري ومسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. One day the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked the companions, "Who is fasting today?" Abu Bakr al-Siddiq raised his hand. He said, "Oh, I'm O Messenger of Allah. Who visited a sick person today?" Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه raised his hand and he said, "Me, O Messenger of Allah. Who given a sadaqah or fed a miskin today?" Abu Bakr al-Siddiq raised his hand and he said, "I'm O Messenger of Allah." And the fourth question, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Who followed a janazah? Who walked behind a janazah today?" Abu Bakr al-Siddiq said, "I'm O Messenger of Allah." Four deeds in one day. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam made that statement, "La yajtami'na fi ahad illa wa dakhala al-jannah." No one would actually do these four deeds in one day, but he will enter Jannah. That is why you should be careful. You should actually strive to get those four deeds together. For example, if you learn that you have a janazah in your community, all you have to do is wake up fasting in the morning. All you have to do is go visit a sick person, give sadaqah or feed a miskeen. This way you end up doing, at least try to work to do that sunnah at least once in your life. But if you can't do it so often, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, anyone who does these things in one day, he will enter Jannah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq immediately upon accepting Islam, the Shahada, upon saying, "Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah," he mobilized himself to da'wah. He actually went and called six of those who were giving glad tidings of Jannah. Uthman ibn Affan came to Islam because of Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf came to Islam because of Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqas came to Islam because of Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Talha ibn Ubaidillah became a Muslim because of Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Zubayr ibn al-Awwam became a Muslim because of Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Wa fi riwaya in a wording, Abi Ubaid ibn al-Jarrah. Six of those who were given glad tidings of Jannah will come in the day of resurrection in the scale of Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Because he was the one who given them da'wah. He's the one who invited them to Islam. How long you been a Muslim? You probably are born a Muslim. How many people did you help to bring to Islam? How many people did you give da'wah to? Look at Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Immediately upon accepting Islam, he mobilized himself. He actually mobilized all of his money. And the athar fi Mustadrak al-Hakim, and the narrator of this author is Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. He said, because he always sees Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu giving, giving, giving. And he said, "One day I had some money, I had some wealth with me. And I said, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the companions to give sadaqah. And I said, today I will beat Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. I will give more than what Abu Bakr gives. I will be more generous than Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu." Umar decided to take half of his wealth and he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, "Ya Rasulullah, this is for the sake of Allah." Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Umar ibn al-Khattab, "What did you leave for your family?" Umar said, "I left half of this." Then while he was standing, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu brought all of his wealth. All of his wealth. And he said, "O Messenger of Allah, this is sadaqah." Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, what did you leave for your family, O Abi Bakr al-Siddiq? He said, "Taraktu lahum," I left for them Allah and His Messenger. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu said, "No way I can defeat you, Abu Bakr. I will stop doing that." Look, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, his ibadah, his worship, the four things that he did, his money. There is a wording out there, there is a hadith out there that is, I know it's authentic, that Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu had to begin with something like 40,000 dinar. He spent it all in the sake of Allah. He freed slaves. Bilal was freed. When Bilal was persecuted by the disbelievers, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam actually hinted and he said, who can free Bilal? Who can free Bilal from slavery? He's being punished by those disbelievers. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anh was the one who went to the master of Bilal radiallahu anh, and he paid his money for his freedom, and he freed him. Amir ibn Abi Fuhayra, it was mentioned that he freed up to 7 companions, male companions and female companions, from slavery. This is Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anh. This is how he reached the status, brothers and sisters in Islam. He worked. He was also a follower of the sunnah of the Prophet, of the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would command him to do something, he would not hesitate for a second to do it. Listen to this. When the people spoke about the honor of the mother of the believer, Aisha radiallahu anha, what we know in the sunnah, hadith al-ifk, there was one of the people whom Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anha basically sponsored. His name is Mustah ibn Uthatha. Mustah. Mustah was sponsored by Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. He used to take care of him financially. And you know what? Mustah was one of the people who circulated the rumors about Aisha radiallahu anha. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu became upset. That is his daughter. And this is the wife of the messenger, his beloved and faithful, beloved friend, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said what? He said what? I will not spend on Mustah anymore. But look, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the verse in Surah An-Nur, وَلَا يَأْتَلِ أُولُو الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَنْ يُؤْتُوا إِلُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Basically, the overall meaning of the verse, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanding Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu to carry on spending on Mustah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, wouldn't you like Allah to forgive your sins? Look what Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu said. I love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love my sins. By Allah, I will not stop spending on you, O Mustah. And the hadith fi sahih al-Bukhari, kitab al-tafsir, narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is how Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu reached that status. It is not because of his birth. It is not because of his name. It is not because of his nearness with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, but he worked. He did a lot of work. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu made a statement. Layla min Abi Bakr. Layla min Abi Bakr al-Siddiq khayrun min Umar wa Ali. A night from Abi Bakr al-Siddiq is better than Umar and the family of Umar. You know what he's talking about? What is Umar is talking about? The night of the Hijrah, Laylatul Hijrah, when the whole family of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu were working for Allah. We're working for Allah. Have you seen anything like this? The daughter Asma carrying the food to the cave. Amir ibn Abi Fuhayra, the shepherd, taking the sheep next to the cave where they could milk and give them milk to eat. Abdul Rahman, the son of Abi Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anh, going around Mecca and finding out what they are plotting and what they are planning, so that he would bring the news to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam at night. And here is in order for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to make decision based on the facts that Abdul Rahman would bring to them in the cave. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anh is guarding and taking care of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the cave. The whole family, brothers and sisters in Islam, working for Allah. What you have done, what did you do for Islam? This is why we are sharing with you the stories of our righteous companions. And the top of the list is Abi Bakr al-Siddiq to motivate you to work for Allah? Is your family, all of your family working for Allah, serving the deen of Allah, giving da'wah, helping the cause of Islam to become successful and victorious wherever you are? This is Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, brothers and sisters in Islam. And this is how he reached that status of the truthfulness, al-Siddiqiyya. And this is how he was given, qualified to be given the glad tidings of Jannah when he was walking in the face of this earth. Brothers and sisters in Islam, don't miss the next episode of Righteous Companions. An event that will show you the quality of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu always has been that merciful, compassionate friend of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we'll shed more light about this in the next episode. But when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam died, the caliber of the leadership of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq emerged. I'm talking about the event of the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the reaction of all of the companions, including the strongest of them, Umar. They all were shaken. But Abu Bakr al-Siddiq was the one who stood firm and wise and helped all the companions to be steadfast. And he helped them to handle the situation wisely and properly. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the faithful friend, the second of the two, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, the beloved companion of the friend of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him. We'll continue the next episode of Righteous Companions. Please join us till then. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Companions spreading the word to the people who needed to hear.